Asana totally transformed the way that I work. I used to be disorganized, constantly trying out different types of planners, different types of software, trying to figure out something that would work for me to get me organized and get my tasks and to-dos all in a central place. But nothing quite worked how I needed. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to get started with Asana for free so that you can create your perfect setup and take control of your work once and for all. Hi, my name is Samantha. I'm an online business manager. I help online coaches and other online service providers organize their business, manage their businesses. If you're new here, welcome. I am so happy to meet you. Please consider subscribing if you like this type of content. And if you're not new here, welcome back. I'm so happy to have you. Okay, so I love Asana so much. Asana is a task and project management system that I think every business owner would benefit from using. Having everything you need in one centralized place helps you make sure that your projects stay on track, helps you manage your team and their tasks and communications with your team, and just makes everything flow more smoothly and efficiently so that you get more done in less time. So all you need is the free version of Asana, but you have to sign up in this specific way. So you're going to go to asana.com and then click this get started button. Then when you get to this screen, you're going to enter your email, but don't just enter your Gmail or Hotmail or those types. You have to enter your domain name email. That's with your domain name like at the end. So your business email, for example, mine is hello@samanthakasbrick.com. So you want that domain name that you have for your business at the end of your email. Not Gmail, not Hotmail, not Yahoo, if that's still a thing. This will give you the best experience in Asana. It just unlocks some features that the other version does not have. Okay, so you're going to type in that email address and then click sign up. And then you will need to head over to your email inbox and verify your email before you get started. Okay, so when you first log into Asana, it will show you your homepage. You can customize this page with a color. You can choose a color here. You can also move these things around, and there's different customization options here that you can play with. But what I want to show you is to click up here. This won't be your image yet, but it'll probably be your initials up in this little bubble here. So you're going to click on it and then go to My Profile, and then you're going to click Edit Profile. And then in here, you can upload your photo. You can enter in all your information here. Especially if you have a team, it's a really good idea to have everyone fill all of this out. And then you can head over to notifications, and Asana loves to send a lot of notifications to your email address. So I would recommend turning most of them off. I have them actually all turned off. I don't have any emails going to my email inbox just because I do check Asana every day. So if you don't, or if you're not in the habit of it, then I would recommend maybe like a daily summary, but you definitely don't want all the emails because they do send a whole lot. Next, you're going to go over to the Hacks tab. This one is just for fun, but make sure that this extra delight is toggled on. This will just give you some extra goodies from Asana, little like rainbows and unicorns and stuff flying across your screen. It's just super fun to have. So go ahead and toggle that on and then click reload to apply changes. Okay, so Asana has its own set of tiers, or like layers of categories really, of organizing your things. So the first tier or layer, it's called Teams. This is something that's missing from the workspace, which is what you would get if you were to sign up with a Gmail account, for example, the non-business email that I was telling you about earlier. So this just adds an extra layer of organization, which I'm all about and just find super helpful because it allows you to just categorize your projects even more. So a way to view Teams, some people might use them in order to separate by what different teams might be working on within their business. Typically though, my clients and myself, we have much smaller businesses. We don't have giant companies. So we don't have that many team members. So I like to use Teams as a level of categorization. So if you think about the main categories or departments in your business, that is how you can think of these teams. So in order to create a team, just click the plus button and then new team. Say this one is going to be for product development.
and create that new team. So this is where you are going to create all of your products. And so then under your product development, you can create a project. This is the next layer underneath teams, is called a project. So blank project. So let's say you want to create a new ebook, continue, go to project. And then the next layer, you have sections and then tasks. So you can separate your tasks into sections, or you can just create tasks without the sections. Sections just add another layer of organizing your tasks. So you could have just a task up here, or you can create this section. So if you want important info, and then maybe you have your links here, and then maybe you want to put your important dates in this, and then you can add a new section for, say, first steps, and then you can go brainstorm, outline, things like that. So that's basically how you can, one way of laying out a project. When you're thinking of all the little steps you need to do, you can lay them out clearly in here. You can also just do a brain dump and then organize them later. Basically, that is how you add tasks. And then to add to your tasks, you can just click into it. And then you can write a description here. You can create your outline right in here, or if you're assigning this task to someone, give them instructions to assign it. You click here, and then like I can assign it to myself, and then I can give myself a due date of tomorrow. You can also move it around between the different sections right in here. You can add it to other projects. You can add subtasks if you want right here. You can also assign those and give them due dates. You can add comments right here, and you can tag someone. So you can say, I have a question about this, and you can tag whoever it is who you want to draw the attention to with the at sign, and then their name will come up like that, and then they will get tagged. Another thing to note within the projects is you can view them in different views. So this is called the list view. You can also view it in the board view like this, and it keeps all of your data, which is really great, in each and every view. And then you can also view it as in the calendar view. So then anything that has a date assigned to it will appear in the calendar view as well. So there's two important sections that you need to be checking every day. Make this a habit if you're starting to use Asana, because this will change the game for you and really help your productivity if you are checking these each day. So the first one is My Tasks. So this is where you will see all the tasks that are assigned to you. So you can see it in this week view like this. You can see it in a month view if you would prefer. You can also see it in the list or board views. I prefer this weekly view because I can see exactly how my week is laid out. Everything is nicely color-coded and just makes it so easy to see what I have to do today. This is the spot to be to stay on top of all of your tasks and make sure nothing slips through the cracks. And you can also, if I didn't have time for one of these today, I can move it to the next day just like that. So the next part that is essential if you have a team, but also important if you don't have a team, because you want to make sure you're clearing it out for when someday you are going to be checking it. So head over to your inbox, and this is where any messages are going to be, any communication from your team. This is where you're going to keep track of your projects that your team is working on, any tasks that they are completing, they have questions on, they're delayed on, anything like that is going to be in here. So it's very important that you check this at least once a day, especially if you have a team. If not, then you're going to just archive your own tasks in here, and I'll show you how to do that. Because you want to make sure that this stays uncluttered so that it's not overwhelming when you do go to check it, and so you can easily just stay up to date on everything. I can see here my assistant wrote a comment here. I can go and I can respond to her. I can send her a little appreciation sticker, or I can just archive it with this. You can also mark these as read or unread. You can create a follow-up task for them that will directly link to this task, and you can save it to your bookmarks. You can like what they did. I'm just going to archive these, and then you can see that they clear out. And you definitely want to do that each and every day. Please don't just look at them and leave them, because it will clutter it up, and then someday it will become super overwhelming for you and you won't want to deal with it. And the inbox is really great for team management and project management, because as you could see, you can comment right within there. You don't even have to leave the inbox in order to respond to your team members and let them know everything they need to know so they can continue getting their tasks done.
Thank you so much for watching. There is so much more to learn when it comes to using and optimizing Asana and customizing it to your own needs. Please like this video if you found it helpful, if you want to see more videos like this, and please let me know in the comments below what questions you have about using Asana so that I can create content for you.